How India became was known to be the most brilliant civilization once upon a time, because they had this knowledge of intuitive ability, intuition, and Avadhan, retention of memory, making your brain like a supercomputer, that you can remember hundreds of numbers at a time. And you can remember, your memory faster than computer. This is possible. And these trainings were given here in the past in the Gurukuls. And that's how, when the foreign invasion happened in India, when they wanted to burn some of the books, and the local pundits there asked them, please give us 24 hours. And the invaders did not understand why. I said, okay, we'll give you 24 hours. In 24 hours, they memorized some of those scriptures and then said, okay, now you can burn any scripture you want. This is in the recorded history. This is what happened in Takshashila. So, the technique to nurture the consciousness to another level was available in this country. Unfortunately, in the past 50, 60 years, 70 years, we never paid attention to this. And so, now the time has come that revival has to happen. Now we will bring back those wisdom to our youngsters and bring the brilliance in them. Same in the field of medicine also. Some of amazing medicinal formulas, medicinal herbs and medical formulas have been discovered in the Ayurveda, in the herbal medicine or Siddha medicines. The Siddhas or the enlightened yogis in the past never lived in compartments. Their life was all-encompassing. Siddhas were not just into meditation, they were into medicine as well. Siddha system of medicine, they knew a lot about the herbs. They knew about the nature, they knew about environment, they knew about the seasons, they knew about astrology and astronomy. They knew about the star positions and the impact of the cosmic rays on our human system. So it was a complete science, holistic approach was there towards life. And now I think slowly we are getting back to that holistic approach in life. Seasons have an effect. The animals around us has an impact. I just saw a video by a scientist measuring his aura first, and he said it is 19 meters. And he goes round the cow, a bull, gir bull, 5 times and then measures his aura. He says it's 128 feet after him. Just going round the cow. And there is another, recently I heard about another research somebody has done, that a person who has some problem, any sort of disease, goes and pats a gir cow and goes round the cow, shows his affection to the cow, and then drinks the milk of that cow. It seems that cow produces those enzymes needed for that person in the milk. And this cow therapy is happening. Somebody is treating people with that. I've asked them, we can also start something like that here, with the hospital. So homes had, and then the tulsi leaves. Tulsi and haldi. Today turmeric is considered to be one of the best preventative medicine. And turmeric cannot be absorbed in the body without pepper, black pepper. And see how nature organizes. Where turmeric grows, pepper also grows. in the same area, in the same climatic condition. And we in India always use both pepper and turmeric in our food or not? Yeah? Now another interesting thing when you talk about Ganpati, Modaka Priya means Ganpati loves sweets. And Ganpati also loves Kapitta Jambu Phalasara Bhakshitam. That is in the shloka it is said. Kapitta and Jambu Phal, that is Jamun. Kapitta and Jambu both control sugar. They both, they're good for diabetes. They arrest diabetic from happening. So when you eat so much of laddu, you have to eat kapitta phal and jambu phal as well. So even the shlokas in the pujas, all this is imbibed in it. Similarly, curry leaves control cholesterol. It is anti-cholesterol. Any fried food, don't you use kadipatta in it, tell me. Chuda banate to kadipatta darte. Vada banate to bina kadipatta ka usme taste nahi aata. Papad ko chhodkar. Papad mein to wo to lagate garlic kya, lasun. Baki sab tali hui cheezo mein kadipatta. Nahi to uske saath kadipatta kahin na kahin hota hai. Puri khate to khali puri nahi kha sakte, uske saath sabji bhi to dalta hi hai kadi patta. Ek Shanmuga Nadan karke ek scientist hai, mile the humko Harvard se, to unhone kaha Guruji, rasam jo hai isme 40 medicinal properties hai. Tamil Nadu ke the wo, isliye unko rasam ka bahut shauk tha. Unhone research karke bataya, kehte rasam mein 40 तरह की गुण हैं, औषधि का गुण है उसमें, medicinal properties है, मतलब सर ऐसे इस देश की संस्कृति में सब रहा है, अभी हमको एक वैज्ञानिक दृष्टिकोण से इसको देखना पड़ेगा, यही है. मैं इसलिए कहता हूँ भारत की संस्कृति चीनी और रेत का मिश्रण है. ऐसे हमारे कुछ ऐसे उठपटांग पद्धतियां भी है. बारिश नहीं आए तो बच्चे को उल्टा लटकाओ मंदिर में और मेंढक को शादी करा दो. मेंढक को शादी करने से बारिश हो जाए और मेंढक वो पता भी नहीं है वो ये क्या करा रहे हैं, वो सोचते होंगे. वो तुम्हारा परमिशन की जरूरत नहीं, मेंढक को किसी के साथ शादी करना तो कर ले, एक नहीं दस. ना तुम उनका रोक सकते हो ना उनका रोका कर सकते हो. तो हमारा इतना बेवकूफी है. किसी ने कहा होगा भाई बारिश नहीं हो रही है, बारिश नहीं हो रही है, करोगे क्या भगवान को प्रार्थना करो. तुम प्रार्थना तो करते, कुछ और बताओ. चलो मेंढक की शादी कराओ, बोल दिया होगा. किसी ने गुस्से में आके कह दिया होगा तुम जाके कुछ करो. हाँ ऐसे करते कई बार लोग, एक ही प्रश्न बार 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 पूछते. हमको भी पूछते, मैं उधर से उधर आते वक्त तक एक ही व्यक्ति 5 बार पूछ लिए होते. भाई मुझे जवाब क्या है, मैंने उत्तर दिया, मेरे याद रहता है. 3 दिन बाद वही प्रश्न पूछा, मैंने कहा देखो उस दिन मैं वहाँ गेट के पास तुमको ये जवाब दिया था. फिर शॉक हो जाते हैं. हाँ अच्छा अच्छा गुरुजी, लगता है गुरुजी सुनी नहीं. ऐसे हम सोचते हैं भगवान भी पता नहीं हमारा प्रार्थना सुनते हैं कि नहीं. 7 अरब लोग दुनिया में हैं, हमारी प्रार्थना भगवान तक पहुँचती है कि नहीं पहुँचती. वेदर गॉड नोज अवर प्रेयर और नॉट, सो कीप शाउटिंग एज लाउड एज यू कैन. No, it's not going to work on this. Yeah? तो ये इस तरह से मूर्ख जो चीज़ें हैं ना, इसको बंद करनी चाहिए. नेपाल में एक मंदिर में ये था कि मैया को खुश करने के लिए, भगवती को खुश करने के लिए, तो 5 चिड़िया हर एक ने वहाँ पर बलि दो। हमने अपने लोगों को वाचरंग बेच के बोला कि ये प्रथा बंद करवाओ, ये गलत है। बंद हुआ वो प्रथा। तो इस तरह से बहुत हमारे यहाँ अंधविश्वास की कोई कमी नहीं है, और वैज्ञानिक चीज़ की भी कोई कमी नहीं। कुछ लोग जो अंधविश्वास के विरोध में हैं, वो ऐसे अच्छे जो वैज्ञानिक तत्व है इसको भी उखाड़ के फेंक देते हैं, और कुछ लोग जो है अंधविश्वास को लेके बैठ जाते हैं। इसलिए मध्यम मार्ग अपनाना चाहिए। क्या इसमें जो तथ्य है, सत्य है, उसका ग्रहण करो, चीनी को ग्रहण करो, रेत को छोड़ दो। उसके लिए तुम्हें चींटी बननी पड़ेगी, निरंकारता में आनी पड़ेगी।